Authorities in Rubanda District initiated a comprehensive campaign aimed at restoring degraded wetlands in the area, and this kicked off last week. This action is part of the government's campaign aimed at restoring wetlands launched last week under tight security and affecting approximately 100 households. Residents of Chenyi and Kabere parishes in Muko sub-county, Rubanda County West, have expressed their discontent with government's forceful eviction and destruction of their crop gardens and trees as part of the wetland restoration. The affected residents observed the destruction of diverse crops such as Irish potatoes, beans, cabbages, maize, eggplants and trees, heightening tension and causing concern among the local community and some leaders. I got a loan of 3 million to purchase maize, beans and Irish potato seedlings, which I had planted here. Unfortunately, they came and demolished everything. With a family of 6 children, this farm was not just a source of food, but also our means of livelihood. I am really devastated because I am stranded and I'm wondering how to support my family. Most families lack food since children had just returned home from school, only to discover that their food has been ruined. Throughout my 30 years of marriage, we have consistently utilized this land for all our agricultural activities. It was only recently that individuals approached us, asserting that this area is designated as a wetland and insisting that we vacate. Other affected residents stressed the need for government compensation before relinquishing their land, emphasizing the long-standing use of these plots and their livelihood. The funds I invested in establishing this garden came from the PDM. I am uncertain about how I will repay this money now. My 3-acre garden of Irish potatoes has been destroyed. Leaders have condemned the actions by the National Environment Management Authority and the Natural Resources Office, asserting that it deviates from the president's directives.
NEMA and the Natural Resources Office claim that they are affecting the presidential directive. The president has never directed them to go and cut people's crops. It is very, very, very unfair and unfortunate, and we condemn it in the strongest terms.
No, any presidential directive that says go and evict people who are more than 2,000 in one day, and we don't have any plan for them.
According to Jenna Mumpire, the Rubanda District Natural Resources Officer, the public was informed about the process prior, and they know the dangers of settling.
What they are, they have just planted, they know we have already stocked, and you know we don't implement. But today we have seen that at least the district officials are here to implement the presidential directive.
At least 100 farmers in Chenyi and Kabere parishes were affected by this wave of forced eviction. Some residents have resorted to recultivating the district gardens, citing a lack of alternative options. Report by Job Namanya for the news in Rubanda.